What's going on, everyone? It's Marcellus back with another video. Today, we got to talk about Baby Dogecoin. We're just going to do a quick little update on Baby Doge. So definitely hit the like button and subscribe. Remember, I'm not a financial advisor. None of this is financial advice. Leave a comment in the comment section. And also, don't forget to come over here to CryptoMillionaires.shop and get you some Crypto Millionaires merch. We got all types of stuff over here from Crypto Millionaires established in 2023, as you can see here at these shirts. And we got more and more and more than that. So definitely check out CryptoMillionaires.shop. It would look amazing on you. It would look amazing on anybody. We have stuff for men, women, all that good stuff. So check it out, CryptoMillionaires.shop. And anyways, let's get started with the video, though. So let's start talking about Baby Doge here. As you can see, you know, since the live stream from yesterday, we've actually dropped down below this support here. And now it's became our resistance. So it's pretty interesting to see. Hopefully, we can get back above this 8Z2250 resistance. But, you know, we are below it now. So we just got to make peace and make do with what we got. But like I said, 8Z21 down here at this support line is going to be that next support line for us. So if we go ahead and continue on this downtrend, then yeah, that next support line, we're going to have to be paying attention to it, because that's probably where we're going to end up going next if we continue to go on this path. But, you know, if we don't continue to go on this path with Baby Doge, and if we go on a different path, then obviously we could become bullish and then eventually get all the way up here to 8Z2350. So that's what we're looking for. We're looking towards 8Z2350, you know, just like how we came back here on the 19th of March, and just like how we came back here also on the 18th of March, we hit the same area. So yeah, we're really looking towards 8Z2350 for our resistance after we get past 8Z2250. But you know, the technicals, I don't like to stay on those too long, because those can get invalidated real quick just by something happening, like geopolitics and stuff like that. But we're going to move on from that. We're going to talk about Bitcoin. So as you can see here with Bitcoin, we were also doing this technical analysis during our live stream yesterday. And it was pretty interesting because we had this wedge, right? But at the end of everything, you can see we broke down below that wedge very briefly. But then we immediately shot right back up to that wedge. And then we started to go between the wedge again. And then we broke out of it again briefly on the upside, but now we're back in that wedge. So we're in a really weird area, and there's actually bearish signals being thrown up. So it could be, or it could mean that we drop back down to 27K flat. And that's where that next support has us at $27,000 flat. And the reason why I say that, you can see here, we're overbought here on the oscillator. And then you can see a very, very small buying wave coming in after that. And that happens because the buying is pretty much slowing down. Now that the buying is slowing down, now it gives the opportunity for the selling to increase. So you're probably going to start seeing some selling here for Bitcoin. This is a bearish signal that we're seeing. If we were to look at it from the 4-hour chart, you would probably see something similar. Yep, another bearish signal being thrown up because the buying is now slowing down and the selling is speeding up. So it looks like we could have that pullback for Bitcoin here. But I still think that we will probably end up hitting 30K before a major pullback. That's if tomorrow comes in good. Like if tomorrow comes in good, like you all know, we got the Fed press conference tomorrow. They're going to talk about the federal interest rate decision, whether they're going to raise it by 25 base points or 50 or not at all. So we're going to see what they're going to do there. And that's pretty much going to determine what is going to happen. So tomorrow is really a really big day for us. So it's going to determine whether we go up to 30K or whether we go back down. So that's why we got to wait for tomorrow. And yeah, it's going to be pretty interesting. 25K could be that support where we hit if we go down, or it could go down lower than that. But yeah, tomorrow is going to be very, 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 very interesting. But yeah, anyways, I'll let you all know what happens tomorrow. Now, moving on to Bitcoin, our Baby Doge. So let's talk more about Baby Doge. We are up 1.8% in the last 24 hours. Shout out to the Baby Doge Army, our volume. 5.5 million, 361 million inside of market cap and all that good stuff here. Yeah, so Baby Doge is just, it's just moving along. It's just moving sideways for right now. And literally, we just got to wait till tomorrow. Like after tomorrow, we should know what's going to happen here with Baby Doge. But it's not just Baby Doge. I mean, if you look at everything, everything's kind of moving sideways right now and waiting for tomorrow. Obviously, XRP is having some different stuff because their lawsuit. So yeah, XRP. I'll make a whole video on XRP, by the way, and why it's popping. But anyways, we're going to talk about more about Baby Doge here, and we'll do a whole video on XRP. But yeah, anyways, with Baby Doge, we now have 1,712,188 holders. So yeah, we're getting more holders by the day with Baby Doge. Since yesterday, we got a good amount of holders, like 170 holders. Not too bad. And also over here, you can see Euquid. They posted this with Baby Doge saying you can now use Baby Doge to shop anywhere in the world. So look, Euquid card. So dear Baby Doge Army, what will be the first thing you consider buying today? If you're still thinking this Baby Doge Army's choice might be a great suggestion for you. And then they have the Spotify $30 gift card that you can buy with Baby Doge. The first product paid by Baby Doge on Euquid shop. So yeah, that's pretty interesting to see. And you can see here shop over 120 million products on Euquid shop with Baby Doge and various payment options. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. And you can come over here to this digital shop. And you can buy all these digital products, right? And yeah, that's if you want to do the digital. Maybe you want to get a digital PC game. You can get all these different games on here on Euquid, and you can use Baby Doge. So let's say you want to buy Sims 3, or maybe you want to buy Battlefield or something. So you would just click it. Obviously, you click it, and then buy now, and then they're gonna show you what do you want to do. When you want to do Web3, and you want to do Binance, Apple. Well, I want to do Web3. All you got to do, connect your MetaMask or connect your wallet, and you can spend directly with Baby Doge. So that's pretty interesting. Shout out to Euquid for doing this. This is pretty big, the fact that we can use Baby Doge to buy stuff. But my real question is, will that 10% be charged when we're using Baby Doge? That's the real question, because if that 10% is charged, it is pointless to use Baby Doge to spend. So I kind of want the developers to clarify on that, or someone that's already used Euquid with Baby Doge. So if you're out there and you've used Euquid, let me know inside the comment section what you all have done, like how you all did it. So let me know how you all, you know, did it, like if you all used Baby Doge to buy something on Euquid, because that's very, very interesting to me. I just want to know, did it require you all to have to pay that 10% tax fee? Because if it did, then it's no point of using Baby Doge as a payment method. But if it didn't charge that fee, then I definitely would say it would be worth it. So I want to see what you all say. But moving on from that, let's talk about the game a little bit. Yesterday, they revealed the game as a chess game. So shout out to the Baby Doge Army and the Baby Doge developers for actually creating this. And you can see the first game to play with Baby Doge will be a classic game of chess. And they look, the keywords, the first game. This isn't the only game they're making. They said the first game to play with Baby Doge will be a classic game of chess. And they said play to head versus other Baby Doges and have the opportunity to win Baby Doge. So yeah, it's going to be like a play to earn game. And then you can see it's in the final stages of development and testing before going live. So they're pretty much testing it before they launch it. So yeah, this is pretty cool and came in with the Baby Doge community. And yeah, that's pretty cool and pretty fun. Moving on from this though, let's talk about something else. And also, I just now noticed this in here. A lot of people are upset because it's a chess game. You got to remember, it says the first game. So obviously, the first game they launch isn't going to be a whole intricate game that's just so complicated. It's like an MMORPG. It's built like World of Warcraft. You got a whole world. You got all this stuff that you can do in it. Like, obviously, their first game isn't going to be that complicated. Like, they got to start off somewhere. Like, the Blizzard developers, they didn't just launch World of Warcraft first. Like, they launched the other things, you know, in beta and test versions. They launched card games and stuff like that. And then when they really got things down pat, they really started to create these MMORPG games. So you can't really expect the Baby Doge developers here to just outright make the best game ever first. Like, this is the first game, and it's a competitive game. And a lot of people do like chess. You know, everyone says this is chess, not checkers. Well, that's exactly what the Baby Doge developers are doing. They're playing chess, not checkers. And it seems like some people in the Baby Doge army are playing checkers. But yeah, we got to start somewhere. You always got to start small and then work your way up. You can't just start large and then work your way down. It doesn't work like that. But moving on from this, though, you can see over here liquidity now at $42.71 million. It is dropping a little bit. Volume at $537,000. And over here on the Baby Doge burn portal, you can see we now have 38.188 trillion burned on the burn portal, 5.3 trillion burned in the last 24 hours in total. And you can see it right now at 204.187 quadrillion. Baby Doge bought through the burn portal, 386 million. So yeah, we're still doing good on the burn portal and all that good stuff. And also over here, we go over to farms. Our farms are still doing all right. We did drop 1% APR right here. It was 35, now it's 34%. but it doesn't matter. You can also see over here we're at 2.18 billion inside of my farms now, which is pretty cool, which is only $5. But also you can see over here we have $157 in here now. So as the price of baby doge goes up, this goes up as well. And moving on over here to DeFi Llama, $50.23 billion. So more money is still flowing into DeFi. Like, if y'all aren't in on any type of DeFi projects, it doesn't even have to be baby doge. You probably want to get in on some DeFi. But like I said, I'm not a financial advisor. None of this financial advice at all. But, you know, DeFi is where it's at. Let's be honest. DeFi is where it's at. But anyways, down here, you can see baby doge now at rank 135. We are going down a little bit inside the DeFi rankings. We need to go back up. But it is what it is. It's whatever. We need to go back up, though. So hopefully we can rise here in the baby doge ranks on DeFi Llama. But anyways, this is all I got for you all today. So definitely hit the like button and subscribe. Remember, I'm not a financial advisor and none of this financial advice. Leave a comment in the comment section, all that good stuff. And come over here and check out CryptoMillionaires.shop if you want to go ahead and pick up some Crypto Millionaires merch. We got Crypto Vibes shirt. We got Crypto Millionaire Established 2023. We got King Bitcoin shirts. We got all this stuff. We got the Crypto Millionaire hoodies. We got all this good stuff. So definitely come here and check it out. And as always, I'll be back with another video.